John Carpenter, one of the most prominent directors of the sci-fi horror genre. A legend in his own right. I always loved the fact that John Carpenter really never held back with his movies. Or when it came to making his movies. When I think about his movies, like, they hit like an honest opinion. He's also one of the most overlooked directors of his time too. You know, coming up around Kubrick, Spielberg, Coppola, Scorsese, David Lynch, David Cronenberg, etc. If you ask me, he was pretty much in a league of his own. But without further ado, hit that like, comment, subscribe. Let's get into it. Okay, for my honorable mentions, I have Dark Star, The Fog, Escape from LA, Big Trouble, Village of the Damned. Had a hard time getting into Dark Star. I thought it was pretty goofy. The Fog, pretty boring, but okay. Escape from LA, still felt like Escape from New York, but a little worse. Big Trouble, I never forget that opening theme. Village of the Damned, I thought it was so funny that Superman was facing off against a whole bunch of kids with supernatural psychic abilities. Like, come on. At number 10, I have Starman. A random alien from a random planet in space takes the form of a young widow's husband. I don't know if it's me, but you barely recognize Jeff Bridges in this. And so, yeah, this movie's pretty much an adult version of E.T. The human and their comrade alien tries to do the best they can to not fall in the hands of the government. Starman is easily the most lighthearted movie John Carpenter has ever put out. I mean, you could throw Memoirs of Invisible Man, but this one here was a lot more compelling. It's also heartwarming. Overall, it's cliche, but still solid. And oh yeah, seeing Jeff Bridges without a beard was pretty mind-blowing. At number 9, I have Vampires. A team of vampire hunters are tasked to hunt down and destroy a group of vampires searching for an ancient relic that will allow them to exist in sunlight. This is probably the last little bit of magic Carpenter had left for horror movies. I like this take on vampires a lot from Carpenter. Very graphic, brutal, dark, with a fantastic story. Also, some grade A special effects. Some pretty cinematography too. Overall, James Wood was a pretty entertaining lead in this. So was the rest of the cast and the action sequences. Great watch. At number 8, I have The Prince of Darkness. This was very mysterious, dark, and brooding. Prince of Darkness almost felt like the thing. Carpenter excels once again with build-up, tension, and suspense in this. And that score, man, crazy. That opening theme though, like, man, that shit, it kind of reminded me of They Live a little bit, but you know, it was there. Yeah, shout out to Carpenter making his own scores to his movies, man. All them bangers. Another really great watch. And man, that raw footage scene at the beginning was so tough. Like, they had one towards the end too, but yeah, very spooky and out of the ordinary. At number 7, I have Christine. So a nerdy kid who gets bullied a lot ends up buying a car, a very old car, which he names Christine. He also has a friend who's the exact opposite of him, who's cool and pretty much a jock. In order to defeat his bullies, the nerdy kid then uses his supernatural car. And so he's pretty much demonically possessed by the thing, you can say. This is also a Stephen King adaptation, by the way, so you know how those go. One thing I find crazy about this movie is how old the high school students look, man. I mean, that's how it was in real life, you know what I'm saying? But this movie, like, bro... And bro, these kids were like straight dangerous criminals too. Like these were different kind of bullies back then. Like, just straight up, just jig you up with a knife. Arnie in this car's relationship reminds me of Peter Parker, Spider-Man, and the Venom symbiote. But overall, great story. Doesn't hold back. Kind of freakish in a way. I also love how scary that Christine car was too, because it was just completely unstoppable. As a matter of fact, man, who y'all got? Christine car or the Batmobile in a fight? Because the Christine car could, man, that Christine car stomping a Tesla Cybertruck. But I know one thing, I'm glad that car didn't have an actual voice to talk though. Oh my shit. Alright, coming in at number 6, I have In the Mouth of Madness. So, a horror novelist, Sutter Kane, disappears. Insurance investigator John Trent is sent to investigate Kane's mysterious disappearance, alongside an editor named Linda Stiles, whom they both have terrifying experiences exploring a supernatural town in New Hampshire. This was very well executed by Carpenter. I do think that the I'm the main character was taken a little too far, you know what I'm saying? But other than that, great visuals, good storytelling, an amazing atmosphere, great cast, amazing leads from Sam Neill and Julie Carmen playing John Trent and Linda Stiles. You also had a young Hayden Christensen in this, who I barely recognized. Carpenter pays a great deal to the H.P. Lovecraft in this. Doom creatures were flat out disgusting, but phenomenal twist too. Nah, no I didn't. I forgot to rank Memoirs of Invisible Man, but that's okay. We're going to put that in honorable mention though. Memoirs of an Invisible Man. Let's talk about it. It ain't top 5 of his for me, but it's definitely in the top 10. But I'm just going to keep it at 100 honorable mention because, man, that is the funniest John Carpenter movie I ever watched. You know what I'm saying? Hands down. And a lot of people don't like it, including Carpenter himself. Man, I'm like, man, this shit is fire. Man, this shit is amazing. I mean, heard the production was very stressful and strenuous, but goddamn, man, they could. He ended up making a whole, you know what I'm saying, underrated gem. Alright, so continue on with Escape from New York. Escape from New York is great 80s cheese with a lot of comfort. I never truly realized how good of a villain Isaac Hayes played, because he was not messing around in this. Yeah, Escape from New York is just one of the ones, man. The setting, atmosphere, the despair, the... Man, the characters, the weird, funky, mysterious characters. Also, the action. At number 4, I have The Thing. Deep in Antarctica, a group of an American research group of scientists are terrorized by this alien species from space that can body snatch humans, basically. Well, not like Invasion of the Body Snatchers, but, you know, they can assimilate. They can. It's not really a physical being. It's, you know what I'm saying, just something you can't see, and they can just take over your whole body and leave you completely possessed. This thing can also turn human and animals into these disgusting, hard to look at creatures. I mean, filthy creatures, bro. And so this mysterious thing just goes around picking everybody off one by one, most of the cast members, man, leaving Kurt Russell, who plays the main character, wary of his crew. I love how mysterious this movie is. This is probably the best body horror sci-fi I've ever watched. Both the special effects and practical effects were wildly incredible, especially for the 80s. The writing and acting was very impressive. Some of it felt kind of genuine. This movie also gave us impactful, mistrustful characters. Amazing ending, though. Keith David is very underrated, by the way. I'm going to be honest. Watching this the first time, I didn't really feel it, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got kind of bored of it. I didn't understand what was going on, but on the second watch... totally different. I'm like, okay, I see why people rave over this movie so much, you know what I'm saying? At number three, I have Assault on Precinct 13. This story is just straightforward. A random group of people hold up in an abandoned police station under attack by a crazy force, overwhelming force of an unstoppable street gang. Man, when I tell you, watching this the first time, oh my god, man, look, this is a movie that where Carpenter just pretty much went all out on. The killer, bro, he made some cold-blooded killers in this movie, man, to the point where they was just soulless humans. Yeah, this was a different type of street game, man. These dudes didn't give a fuck about nothing. A very brutal, dark, menacing crime thriller action that was amazing from beginning to end. Despite this being a low-budget 70s flick, there was some good dialogue in here. I love how the plot and story was very simple and straight to the point. John Carpenter excels with his B-list and C-list cast once again. The tension carried by the cautious characters in this was very satisfying to watch. Yeah, man, I love these kind of movies, though. They're just so easy to get into. Like, I was just zapped in the whole time. You'll never get these kind of movies again, man. That one scene with that girl, man, being shot by that dude, man. Oh, I was like, oh, shit. I couldn't believe it. I was like, damn, it's crazy. Highly recommend all my movie lovers to watch it if you haven't. At number two, I have The Day Live. We get Rowdy Roddy Piper discovering a pair of sunglasses that are capable of showing you how the world really works, and he sees the world for what it really is, which is a world ran by skull-faced aliens who, you know, takes on humans. And these aliens appear to be human without the sunglasses. These demonic, mind-controlling aliens are just hell-bent on dominating the whole world, pushing their agenda for a one-world government. The media and the government using all these subliminal messages to keep the human people sedated and sleep. Man, I don't care, man. This movie shows you exactly what's going on in the world today, just about. Yeah, I don't care. Yeah, argue with a wall. Yeah, this is a movie you must watch before you die. It's amazing, incredible, top to bottom. Oh yeah, it has the greatest fight sequence of all time in film history. I remember watching this movie for the very first time when I was little sometime, and man, that scared the absolute shit out of me. Golly, the way those alien creatures looked, oh my god, ain't no way they control the whole world. What the nah. Finally, at number one, we have Halloween 1978. A straight horror slasher classic with a very iconic theme. Like I say again, Carpenter never missed with these scores. It's a masterpiece, hands down. The pacing is great. The story is amazing. Characters, all that, man. 10-10, top to bottom. Carpenter being able to curve his way around by not having blood to have in this movie, you know what I'm saying? To make the kills look crazy. It was very impressive. Its atmosphere and fall setting is immaculate. It's something about this movie, this particular Halloween, that is still daunting, man. Like, its calmness is so intense. Like, now the thing, They Live, they can be out there as the best. Assault on Precinct and the Mouth of Madness, but Halloween is the number one hit. So that just about wraps it up for the John Carpenter top 10 best movies of all of his. I had a real fun time watching his filmography, going through it. I'm gonna have to just make some analytical videos for some of his movies, man. because Carpenter just brings a different attitude towards the game. But with that being said, I appreciate y'all for watching. Stay tuned for the next vid. And subscribe, comment any of your thoughts, like, share. See y'all in the next video. Peace. Darts out.